주가
mantra is beautiful mantra from the Kundalini tradition. It's the invocation to call all our teachers into the gathering here. So as we chant together across the world, consciously bringing in all our teachers, all our teachers. Can you imagine the power across the world? Bringing all our teachers into our consciousness as we chant this beautiful mantra together.
Juga gure name,
can save a soul like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now this to all the people in Minneapolis and to George and his family, and an end, please God, an end to this conflict, an end to this conflict. Amazing grace. Said a prayer for the homeless. I pray no life is lived in vain. I lit a candle and I stepped out into the pouring rain. And I went looking for the mother inside. World turning, tears of redemption and forgiveness. Across that river I was looking for a witness. I was reaching out, reaching for the mother inside. And the rain fell down like the tears of the virgin, tears of joy for all souls emerging as we reach for the mother inside. The sun rose at midnight. Everything changed. My plans and my dreams, they were all rearranged. Went singing for the mother inside. Yamaya, Shakti. Durga. same under the skin. We're all unprotected, searching, searching, searching for the mother inside. Birth and death in every breath, one lover after another as we search, search for the mother. What did we do? We took too much of you. Looking outside, for the mother inside. Looking outside. Our voices together in meditation. Today we'll chant a mantra, 108 cycles. Shall we, Deva? Shall we do that instead of the Om? It would be nice.
Instead of the Om, and then go to the Gayatri.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Aham prema.
Aham prema, which means I am love. Aham prema.
This is beautiful. This is the great reminder.
Yes.
I am love.
And this is a birthday gift to Sandra and to Yolanda. Today.
Can you come over a bit more? I feel
yeah.
I'm too much in the middle of the spring.
Mm-hmm.
Lift up a bit and I'll open your air.
Happy birthday, Sandra and Yolanda. And also I've been feeling Katja, with amazing grace. Just want to say a big love to you, Katrin.
Just four syllables for this mantra, so close your eyes for a moment. Let's come back home again. Let's come back into our meditation temple. Let our minds go, nothing to think, nothing to want, nothing to remember.
Thank you.
Join David with the mantra on. Eyes open, close your eyes for a moment.
Before we embark on our journey with the seven chakra Gayatri mantra, we can already visualize our seven chakras. It's best to do with your eyes closed, and to just see them all as the energy centers they are, like light points. Whatever is more easy for you to visualize them in the along your spine, the back of your body, or along the front of your body. And the appreciation of the energy of each one of these energy centers. Each one contributing to the wholeness of this human experience. habitur varium, pargo diva, sia diva in Dio iona. Prachodaya. Third eye chakra, sacred cosmic yes, Om. Some more thoughts on fear and trust and love. And you know, there's not many things in life that we all agree on, you know, that everybody agrees on. But I think there's one thing that in the world of food that everybody agrees on, and that's sugar. Like, I think there's no diet which says eat more sugar. I think that's one thing where everybody aligns.
I don't think so.
real sugar, white sugar.
Yeah,
like
many
sugar.
People like real sugar.
Yeah, they like it, but there's no diet or there's no health regime which says eat sugar.
Ah.
And the same with worry and fear. There's no teachings or no enlightened ones who tell us worry as much as you can, be afraid as much as you can, because that's really the
Osho said go deep into your fear.
No, but he didn't say be more afraid.
No,
no,
that's true.
And and you know, I used to have this belief system. I don't have it that much now, but I wonder if you can relate to it. I'm always a bit of I'm a planner, you know. I like to look ahead and I like to make sure that everything is planned as best I can, and you know, quite the opposite of Nitin, I think. And you know, planning and worrying kind of can, it's like blurry edges, you know. So I realized that I had this belief system that everything is going to work out at the end, but I do have to worry about it. Like, at some point you have to suffer. I think maybe there's some German blood in there or something. Either it doesn't work out in the end because you didn't worry before, then it doesn't work out and then you suffer then, or you worry before so you suffer, and then it all works out because you've paid the price. It's really, I could feel it in my system,
yeah.
Like,
yeah.
You can't have it easy, you can't just not worry about it, and then it works out, because, you know, like, that's too easy, and...
Have you dropped that yet, or are you still...
I can still catch myself, but there is actually an evolution, there's actually a growth, inner growth that's happening, and it's a really nice feeling, like, wow, I used to, you know, that trust that things are really guided the way they are, and that they always work out much, much, much better than we could ever imagine, ever plan. And so just in case you're going through something where you're worrying or you feel the fear, just to remember, you know, these things are always in, it's divine timing, it's in God's hands, and we don't know the full picture. And there must be so many situations in your life you can think of where this has been proven to you, you know, where you feel like, wow, I didn't imagine it could, you know, work out that way, or I didn't see it going that way, and now I realize why it was meant to be. So
I have just a song for you.
What's the song?
When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. Let it be, let it be, let it be, now let it be. Speaking words of wisdom, let it be. When the broken-hearted people living in the world agree, there will be an answer, let it be. I wake up,
and though they may be parted,
well, there is still a chance that they will see. Whisper words of wisdom, let it be. night is cloudy, there is still a light that shines on me. Shine until tomorrow, let it be. I wake up to the sound of music. Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom.
Answer?
That's the answer to everything. So let's sing on the beach. Well, we're trying to, if we keep playing, we'll get through all your requests. Thanks, Donna. This is another song that many of you asked for. We'll finish here with this. This is, it's not so despondent as you might feel. Just something you might relate with. I need a beach. I need a place in the sun. Somewhere out of reach. Somewhere I can run free. Free from a world full of trouble and pain. I love the sun. I love the rain. I need a place in the shade, somewhere I can forgive myself for all the mistakes that I made. Free from a world full of trouble and stress, my spirit's strong but my mind's in a mess. I need a beach. Doesn't have to be in Saint-Tropez.
I don't mind.
Venice Beach, down in West LA. That'll do me fine. Whoa. Copacabana, Malibu. Just need some sand under my feet. Give me a little rocking band playing the reggae beat. Call me a coward, say I'm out of touch, but it's the human touch I'm missing so much. I need a beat. Take me down to Blackpool Town, Southend-on-Sea. A realist beach, clothing optional, that's fine with her and me. I got some good friends down in Byron Bay. You know, they got some beaches down there, blow your troubles away. Just need some time to get myself straight, slow down my mind and meditate on this world full of troubles and fears, meditate on this ocean of tears. I need, I need a place I can go, ride with the tide, go with the flow. Call me crazy, call me brave, I just gotta catch me a wave. I need a beach, wash my spirit clean, dancing with my baby in the moonlight waves, that kind of scene. Oh Lord, if you can hear me, please send me down an ocean breeze. I need a beach. You know, Osho always said laughter is really important. Humor is going to save us, and it's a weird thing to say in these times, but somehow we've got to dig deep. But we always have the possibility for a sense of humor. And the Dalai Lama himself once was asked, what are the three main ingredients, the main qualities on a spiritual path? And one of those three qualities he mentioned was a sense of humor out of the three. Of course, compassion was another, and kindness. But to have a sense of humor is not an easy thing to have in this day and age. So it's going to save us. It's a thing that we have to dig deep. Unless you're from Liverpool, everybody in Liverpool has a sense of humor. maybe in Glasgow too. Yeah.
Actually, dig deep or fly high, because if we can see this a little bit,
John Lennon,
a little bit from above, a little bit from a different viewpoint, it is all pretty ridiculous what's going on.
Oh,
so
God.
We
oh
can
God.
Have a
oh
chuckle.
God.
And Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu, which means may all beings be happy, may all beings be free. May all my thoughts, words, and actions contribute in some way to the happiness of all beings.
Can make this mantra happy now? Because it's a happy, it's a great nature.
Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu, sukhino bhavantu. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Samasta sukhino bhavantu. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Loka samasta sukhino. Samasta sukhino bhavantu. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Take a moment to namaste each other, please, across the world. A little moment of connection, cosmic connection with each other, a sense of forgiveness, compassion, and gratitude. Our three qualities in our global Gayatri Sangha. Gratitude, forgiveness, and compassion. Namaste.
Namaste.